This is Eric. I'm going to talk about geocoding, both within and outside of QGIS. Geocoding is really useful when you have data, such as this data from the NYC Open Data Portal. It is a list of businesses licensed by the Department of Cultural Affairs. It has a lot of businesses in here, and it doesn't have a latitude and longitude associated with them or any other geographic data that we can use. So, but it does include the address broken up pretty nicely for you, as you can see here. And as long as you have the address, you can usually find a geographic point for it, and that process is called geocoding. So, geocoding, mostly you're going to be doing that using a service online, and most services online, you basically are uploading a spreadsheet and getting back a geocoded spreadsheet, so a spreadsheet with latitudes and longitudes included. One such service you might have heard of is Google Maps. They have geocoding built in, and there is a QGIS plugin that gives you access to Google Maps. It's the plugin actually has a ton of stuff in it. It's called MMQGIS, if you look that up. You can find it online, and if you go to geocode, yeah, you can see the documentation for it here. You don't have to do that though, you could just go into your plugins and manage and install, and then find search for MMQGIS. I already have it installed. And once you do, you have a new menu in QGIS, MMQGIS, and there's a geocode section, and it brings up this dialog. You need to input a CSV file, and specify the fields that go with the pieces of data that a geocoding service would look for. So geocoding service, ideally, you give each of these four things separately to the geocoding service. If you're missing the country, you're going to be fine. If you only have a city and state, you're only going to get data that accurate. So you're only going to get city level data if you do that, like the middle of the city or city hall or whatever the service considers the center of that city. So ideally, you have the street address, the city, and the state at the very least. And then you pick Google Maps or OpenStreetMap. Google Maps is often going to be a bit better, at least right now. OpenStreetMap has a little ways to go with addresses, especially in the US, but it's getting there. And then you select an output shapefile and a spreadsheet for basically the errors to go into. So I downloaded the whole spreadsheet from the city's Open Data Portal, and I filtered it down just to pawnbrokers to try to make it a little bit smaller. That still had 500 addresses in it, and that would take a little while to do here. So for the purposes of demonstration, I cut that down to 25. So I have 25 rows in here. And this is basically the same exact data as is online, except filtered down and excerpted. And this street address field was not here. I had to add this. So sometimes, basically, we had the address building and the address street name. But if we look back at the geocoding dialog, we only have room for a street address. So you need to concatenate the building number and the street name. You don't want 608 and then 8th Ave. You want 608 at 8th Ave. And I don't really want to get into your how your spreadsheet program works. I'm using LibreOffice here. You might be using Excel or something like that, but basically you're going to have to use a formula. And I don't know Excel well enough to say whether this formula would work there. It's worth trying. Basically, I'm just saying concatenate the field with the address building with a space so that we have a space between the two fields. Otherwise, they're smushed together. And then the next field, which is the address street name. And I copied that formula into every row in this column. And now I have these nicely concatenated street addresses. Okay, so that's a requirement for using this geocoding service. If you don't have the street address split out, for instance, in this column, you have the street address all put together with commas. If you have that, it's not going to work too well for you with this plugin. You really need to have it separated out the way we do with the street address, the city, and the state. Don't worry about the zip code or the country. Okay? If you have these four things, you can geocode these and it doesn't take too long. So let's go back to our dialog and find that data. I have it right here. And so this is where you have to associate your fields with what's in the spreadsheet. The plugin guessed the wrong field here, the wrong column for this field rather. And you see that it found no country. That makes sense. And it found city and state. Pretty convenient. Okay. And I'm putting it in this shapefile. And it wants a spreadsheet to put the errors in. I'm going to just put that on my desktop and overwrite whatever is there. That's fine. Okay, when I hit OK, it's going to look like it's not doing anything at all, which is a little disconcerting. But if you look down here in the bottom left, you can see that it is working. And you can see that's kind of slow. It's actually over the internet, it's for each individual address, it is asking for those. Okay, so it can take a while. If you're doing all 500 of these, you might want to go grab a sandwich. Okay, so we have a bunch of points. Doesn't necessarily look like anything, but I'm pretty sure it worked. Let's see. I'll underlay the toner tiles. Why not? Let's make those. Okay. They're kind of hard to see right now. That's better. Okay, so you can see that it worked. And at least they're all in New York City. That's a pretty good sign. If I zoom to layer, it goes right here. And if I find my errors, should be on my desktop. Not found. It is empty. See, it's starting to open it and it just has the headers. That's a good sign. That means it found all of them. The other thing you're going to want to check in this case, look at the attribute table for the layer. And you see that on the left, everything is exactly the way it was in the spreadsheet. But if we keep going over, we get two new columns. One is the address type, street address in this case. And I can't get over to it. I'm going to have to make the window bigger. The other one can be useful sometimes. It really depends on what you're doing. So this is address location. So rooftop means it actually found the building, and that is the location of the building. And that is a building in Google's database, presumably. These range interpolated ones, that means it didn't find the exact building, but it guessed based on the other street numbers on that street. So it saw, for example, this third one. We see that it was looking for 318 to 320 Third Ave. It might have something to do with the fact that it is this range. But basically it means it didn't find 318 or 320, and it but it guessed based on where, say, 300 and 400 are. It guessed somewhere in between. Often that's good enough. Most of the time you're going to be happy with that. If you're doing something very, very, very precise, you're going to have to be pretty skeptical about things like this and double check those. But if you just want to make a nice map like this and say, hey, here are 25 pawnbrokers, it's going to do just fine. Okay? So that is geocoding using the MMQGIS plugin in QGIS and Google Maps. There are other services online. There are a bunch. The Census Bureau has one, but I think it's not working right now. I really wanted to show it to you. Let's see. Gonna wait for that to load. Okay, so Census Geocoder, this is more of an informational page, but it's provided by the US Census Bureau. You can look up to 1,000 addresses at a time. And it's very, very specific about how you format your spreadsheet. It's a little annoying. You have to add a unique ID if one doesn't exist, and then otherwise it's pretty much what we had for doing it in MMQGIS. House number and street name, the street address, the city and state, and then a zip code instead of country here. So if you have a spreadsheet formatted like this with exactly these things, you have to get rid of your other columns. Then this geocoder will work. Where is it? It's here. Okay, let's see if that loads. It was not loading 5 minutes ago. Maybe it is now. Okay, so it's not looking like it's going to, but it's totally worth a shot. It's probably working now, whenever you're viewing this, it's probably just temporarily down. So that's one option. That's one free option provided by the Census Bureau. There are plenty of commercial options, and there is this site, GPS Visualizer. They have a batch geocoder. Batch meaning you can do more than one at once. A lot of sites let you do one address at a time. Not super useful. So this lets you use either Bing, Google, or MapQuest. I'm just going to use Bing because I already have that set up. And what you have to do is enter an API key, and that identifies you, and these services will limit you based on your key, basically. And the way you get a key is pretty easy. So you click that Get a Key button, and it has directions for each of the three services. You click on a link, create a login, create a key, and then you just copy and paste that key into this field. I shrank the field down so you couldn't really see it. It should mostly work. There are a bunch of disclaimers all over this page, this side and this. These are all disclaimers. The sites providing the data only allow you to perform a few thousand lookups a day. So you might have to shuffle through services if you have a lot to geocode. You might have to split up your data and bring it all back together. That can be painful. If you're going to do that, just be careful and make sure that you don't lose any data in the process. But I'm going to show you how to do just our 25 addresses rather. I'm just going to copy and paste these over and see what happens. We might have to fiddle with it a little bit. I did not test this file earlier, so we'll see what happens. These are separated by tabs the way I pasted them in. See, there are no commas in here, just tabs. If you opened your CSV in a text editor, though, you would see it with commas. And okay, let's see what it does. So it should show us progress as it goes. So it's outputting our data here. And over to the right, we should be seeing, latitudes and longitudes. It's a little hard to read right now because the tabs aren't lining up. It gives us a lot more data about how precise it is and the source and things like that. You see that the column all the way on the right is how precise it is. So some of them are on the street, some of them are address. That one's by zip code. Okay. I think it's done. Is it done? Yes. So I can select all of that, copy it, and open up a new spreadsheet and paste it in. Hopefully your spreadsheet program is smart enough to just pull in whatever you pasted. I hit Control V and I got this. Looks perfect to me. I'm going to hit OK. So we see latitude, we see longitude. Those all look like latitudes and longitudes that are in the general vicinity of New York City. That's great. Some of these, I'm a little worried about some of these precision listings. They're at the neighborhood level and the postcode level. That's not nearly as precise as what we were getting before. So why don't we open that up in QGIS and see how it compares? I believe I have this in my favorites. All right, I need to save the file first. Going to call it Pawnbrokers Bing. Saved it as a spreadsheet, and I shouldn't have. I should have saved it as a .csv. That's okay. That's all okay. QGIS. All right. So I need to open this as a delimited text layer, as you might remember from previous videos. Browse, find the spreadsheet. It's on my desktop. Okay. So it looks like it's loading the spreadsheet just fine. And it looks like it found that the X and Y fields are in here. Okay. I don't think there's anything else to worry about. I'm going to hit OK. And let it know that we are in 4326. Okay. Let's see how these compare. Okay, some of them match really well. Some of them are pretty far off over here. We can figure out what's going on with these by looking at the attribute table or using the identify features tool. I'm going to click on this and see. Looks like So it looks like it probably got. It looks like it got confused because the data is kind of weird. Let's see. I'm not sure where it got Huntington. Is that even in here? Okay, so it is in the here. Okay. So that's a pretty big red flag that it geocoded 724 Amsterdam Avenue to 724 New York Avenue in Huntington instead of in Manhattan. So I'm not doing this to say that Bing or the site that I used is bad. I'm doing this to show you that you have to be kind of precise when you're geocoding. You have to tell the geocoder exactly what it wants to hear, and you have to give it no more than that. So in this case, we had kind of a big file that included, remember, it didn't have the street address quite set up, and it didn't have, it just wasn't really clear, and some of it was really redundant. So what I'm going to do is go back and do the same exact thing, but in this case, I'm just going to copy this full address field. So I'm going back to my GPS visualizer. I'm going to select all of that, delete it, and paste in just the full address field. And I'm going to say that it's just a raw list this time. Okay. So now I'm going to start geocoding again. Oh no. Oh no. Okay. Delete. No. Okay, I'll wait till it's done and delete it. It looks like it's doing much better this time. You see that the precision is at the address level most of the time now. Okay, let me delete the other results that I forgot to get rid of back here. Okay, let's go. Maybe I deleted too much. Sorry about this. Okay, so I am going to select all of this and put it into a new spreadsheet. Again, when I hit Control V to paste it in, it brings up this dialog, which looks fine. Oh, I see. Something went wrong here. Okay, that's probably because that was my fault. I broke it. Okay, I'm going to fix that here by inserting a new row. This happens sometimes when you're working with data. And okay. So what happened is I lost the line breaks between rows. So they ended up getting smushed together, and I got one really long row, and I'm rectifying that currently. Okay, great. That looks much more like what it should look like. I don't know why I made that one big. That is the precision. What I want to make big is the address. Okay. So What we see here is the address that we gave Bing on the right, and the address we got back from Bing on the left, I believe. Let's compare to the original data. Okay, ours was the one in all caps. So we have this one in all caps, that's ours. This is the one we got back from Bing. But if you look at them one by one, they look like they're pretty much exactly the same. They're capitalized better. There's this weird one, the 318, the 320. They changed that to just 318. That happens sometimes. I'm going to insert rows above and name these because I think I broke it earlier. So that's lat long address corrected. I don't think there's anything in this column for some reason. Source and precision. Save that. And I'm going to call it pawnbrokers Bing 2. That's fine, that's fine. Do the same exact thing in QGIS. Add the limited text layer. Browse for it. Number 2. And it found lon and lat. Yay. And I'm going to hit OK. And it is in 4326, so that's great. Okay, now if I turn off my first attempt, you can see that these match exactly now, or pretty nearly exactly. You can see some of these, they're like slightly off from the center, and that's going to happen when you're geocoding, period. They're using different data sources and they are not going to agree all the time. But, and you're going to have to, if you're doing something where precision matters a lot, you might have to try out a few geocoders and see how they work out. Okay, so just to recap, I know I went through a lot of steps there to get it in a shape that worked with Bing on GPS Visualizer. So GPS Visualizer, you can either just have one address per line, if you have just like a text file with these, or if you can copy one column over, you can just copy and paste that in and say, okay, each line just treat that as a mailing address, and it will do that. If you have a spreadsheet with the street address, city and state and zip code all nicely defined, you can paste that in. But if you have too much information, like in this case, we have full address, address building, address street name, street address, you're going to confuse the geocoder. It doesn't give us the option to say, this is the column you should use for the street address. It just doesn't give us that option. So you need to narrow that down. I think it would have worked just as well if we had copied and pasted this part over, because this is tabular and pretty easy to figure out from the geocoder's point of view. Okay, so that is geocoding with both QGIS using Google Maps and with GPS Visualizer. There are other geocoders out there. When you're searching, you want to search for batch geocoders. And good luck.